My YouTube channel recently has passed 2 million views, and that's bleh. I know that 2 million views might not be a lot in this day and age where numbers are everywhere and they are big numbers that you see every day, viral videos here and there, and there are even YouTubers who can get more than 2 million views in a day. So I know that 2 million might be like meh, but I don't compare myself to other YouTubers. Instead, I compare myself with myself 5 years ago when I first started making this YouTube thing. 5 years ago, I was practically unknown in the internet sphere. Nobody knows who I am. But today, 5 years later, I have 2 million views on my YouTube channel, 3 million page views on my blog, 100,000 likes on my Facebook page, 60,000. There are huge numbers in my life that I couldn't imagine 5 years ago. So therefore, it's a big deal for me. Although I try my best not to get these numbers into my head, I try my best to look at it in a different perspective. Instead of feeling like proud and over my head about these numbers, I feel a bit worried about it, because I look at these numbers and I think to myself, this is a huge responsibility. The number 2 million to me, among many things, it means trust. It means that people are actually taking some time, some precious time from their day to spend watching my videos, to listen to what I'm about to say. That's huge, to be honest, and I am honored that you spend the time. I appreciate it, but I feel worried and I feel responsible for making this time trustworthy. Trust is never a small thing when you talk about human interaction. Trust is something that you have to protect and you have to earn. It's not something that people can give to you just willy-nilly like that. However, having said that, being in my position right now, being in the public eye and being the kind of YouTuber that I am, people have given me what I call inappropriate trust. Don't get me wrong, I am grateful and appreciative of your trust. It's just that you can't trust me with everything, especially things that I don't have qualification for. For example, just because I make videos that is Islamic in nature, that doesn't mean that suddenly I became a sheikh, I became a scholar, I became an ustaz where you can ask me fiqh questions, ask me like detailed, complicated questions about Islam. Those kind of questions, you need to direct them to the appropriate people. Similarly, I may know a little bit about medicine, like if I have a fever, I take Panadol, for example, but you can't ask me to diagnose you with a specific illness because I am not a doctor. I know some things about medicine, but you can't trust me with diagnosing you and offering you treatment. You have to go to the people with the correct qualification. Even in my own academic field, which is psychology, that's my degree, that's my field, that's my forte, that's my cup of tea, you know? Even in my field, I am still not comfortable being called a psychologist because I only have a degree. I am still like in the beginning phase. I'm an amateur psychologist at best. So the message here is simple. Don't put your trust to just anybody. Be very specific and careful about the trust that you put in, because your trust is valuable. It's more valuable than money. So you should be very selective in who you trust with specific issues. So that's the message for today. Thank you for the 2 million views and thank you for watching. Thank you for your time. I appreciate it and thank you for your trust. Until next time, see you on Friday. Assalamualaikum, goodbye.